everyone, and welcome to my March bullet journal. So this theme is inspired by all of the gorgeous magnolia blossoms that are blooming around here in the Bay Area. They have this really gorgeous color pattern here where the majority of the blossom is like this deep wine color with pink, and then they fade out into white. So that's the main colors that I chose to go for this entire spread. And as you see here, I started off with an initial sketch, and I did use a reference photo that I found online that I'll link below if you want to use the same one. And I started off with that sketch, and then I went in with my Sigma Pigma Micron in the 0.3 size and started doing the line work for this sketch. I wanted the colors of this palette to be kind of minimal because I'm going to be going in with that gold foil as well. So I decided to keep the branches and the leaves of this spread in just the black and white ink work, and then color in the blossoms with my Tombow brush pens. So after filling in the initial line work, as you see, I go in and add a couple more details with the Pigma Microns to get a little bit more depth and to make it so that the flowers and the branches and the leaves aren't quite so flat looking. I also wanted to do something special with this spread, so that's why I decided to go with the gold foil in the background, which you'll see in a bit. And that's because March is my mom's birth month, and my mom is truly my biggest fan when it comes to my bullet journals. Every month she asks me to bring over her bullet journal, or she'll come over to my house so that she can see and look at the work that I've done for this spread, so that she can see what the new theme is every month, and she just absolutely loves it every single time. There's literally never been a spread that she hasn't been like 10 out of 10 supportive with. So I wanted to do something special for her, and I knew that the colors would work, and I know that she loves flowers just as much as I do. It's actually one of my favorite things to draw. Even when I was in high school, a lot of my assignments or like my homework would have little flowers in the margins because I would draw in them during class when I was a little bit bored. And so flowers, for some reason, were always the thing that I gravitated towards most when I decided to doodle something. So as you saw, I went in with my Tombow brush pen and I used the darker color. I'll put the color specifics in the description so you guys can see, but I went in and colored the parts that are closer to the center in that dark color, and then I went in with the lighter pink shade and spread that out more towards the top, but leaving the tips of the petals completely white because that's the way that a lot of the magnolia blossoms around me look. I then went in with these gold watercolor paints, which are really great, and I actually got them as a gift for Christmas from my partner, and I absolutely love them. They make the page look so gorgeous. I went in with the antique gold shade and then also the champagne gold color shade because I kind of wanted something that was in between the both of them. So I wanted to include a little fun fact about magnolias, and specifically the magnolia blossoms. So apart from being just so beautiful to look at, magnolias actually taste very faintly of ginger, and they can be used as a ginger replacement. And so I suppose the other fun fact is that they are edible, they are perfectly safe to eat, and that you can make things like magnolia syrup and magnolia jam that taste like ginger, and you can include it on your toast or in cookies or something like that. So you know, in case any of you guys are adventurous out there, but they are safe to eat. And then on the other side, I did the same thing where I just did a rough sketch and then filled that in with the same colors and my Pigma microns that I did for the main cover page. And this is going to be the header for the habit trackers. Then, as you see, I just glued down my cover page. I initially tried to create this illustration and put it directly into my bullet journal, but I got a little overzealous with the watercolor paints and I painted the watercolor first and then realized that I wasn't going to be able to put my illustration on top of that. So I went in with a piece of scratch paper and just redid the cover page. And then, as you see, I put in the habit tracker. I did the exact same thing by accident. Then I went in and started outlining my habit tracker boxes. I track 9 different habits, and as you can see, I use the same pink brush pen to outline all the headers, and then I went in with a gold tip extra fine liner to both put in the days of the week and the titles for all of the habits that I am tracking for this month. I then went in and I used my Tombow Furunosuke pen to add the lettering for March. That's one thing that I don't really like about this spread is my calligraphy, or rather lack thereof, throughout the entire spread. I mentioned it last month or in one of my previous spreads that I really want to get better at my calligraphy, and I just need to practice more, because that is one thing that I felt was lackluster in this spread in particular. For my calendar spread, I like to have the full 2 pages, and so I went in along the top with the same branch of my magnolia, then going in with my same Sigma micron and doing the outline. For me, I like to have it where the cover page and the calendar page are usually the 2 most time-consuming elements. For me, because everything else I like to keep quite minimal. And so this was no exception, although I will say that as someone who really likes to draw flowers, it kind of becomes easier after a while, and definitely after you've drawn a couple blossoms, you kind of just know what you want them to look like, and so you end up drawing them a lot faster. And for those of you that like to have a 2-page calendar spread like myself, these boxes are 6x6 dot grid spaces. Because these blossoms are smaller, I didn't have to use too much of the pen, and so for the Tombow brush pens, I kind of used them a little bit more conservatively because, again, I wanted to keep that white border around them as well. And then to keep the page cohesive, I went in with the same brush pen and marked out the headers for all of the days of the week, as well as my intention spread. The reason why I like to have a 2-page calendar spread is so that I have more than enough room to write any upcoming dates that I might have, or birthdays, or holidays, or anything like that. And in the month of March, I will be traveling. Like I said, it's my mom's birthday in March, and so we are going on a trip together to celebrate, and I hope to bring you guys along. So that's another video that might be coming soon. Actually, it will be coming in March. I just don't know how soon, or maybe even April, because it is kind of towards the end of March, but just be sure to keep an eye out for that. And I think it's going to be really fun, so I definitely can't wait to show you guys a little bit of what we get up to and where we're going, because I'm not gonna spoil that just yet. Then to bring in the gold element, I went in with my extra fine liner and wrote out the days of the week in that same gold font and also the title. Off to the side, I have my intention section, which I have really been enjoying using in February and January, so I wanted to continue that theme in March. Next, we're moving on to my first weekly spread, and as you guys could see, I did initially just sketch out one flower petal, but I decided to replace that with an entire little magnolia blossom. I also think that this spread could work really well for any number of flowers, so I know that a lot of people, usually for spring, they will do something more akin to a cherry blossom or a sakura blossom, but I really think you could do anything with this. So there are so many flowers that bloom in the springtime, and I think you could pick whichever one is your favorite and incorporate that as well. So as I normally do, I keep my weekly spreads quite minimal, so that blossom at the top left corner is really the only element that I'm keeping in this spread. And the same is going to be true for all of my other weekly spreads. I then went in with my gold extra fine liner and put in all of the weekdays and the dates as well. I figured that I could incorporate the pink and the marine color when I write my daily tasks and reminders throughout the week, so those colors will still be present throughout my weekly spreads as I go in and fill them out. Next, we're moving on to my last spread, and because I wanted to include a section for my reflections, which again is something that I've also been doing since January of this year, I wanted to have the header or the place where I write the number of all of these with a magnolia blossom, but again, I think they ended up looking a little bit more like cherry blossoms in this one. And then for the last day, to have the bloom, so it kind of looks like these are all petals that fell off of the magnolia bloom. Then to mark out the spaces for each of these days, I went ahead and used the arched pattern that you see in front of you, and I filled that in with the gold extra fine line as well. And the reason I did this was to kind of mirror the same as the cover page, to kind of bring back the cohesiveness of the entire spread. I don't know if any of you guys have had trouble using the extra fine liner, but I know that when I first started using the extra fine liner pens, specifically the gold or silver or really any of the metallics, I had such a hard time using them. And I think it was because I was putting too much pressure on the tip of the pen as I was using it. And so as I've gotten more comfortable using them, I found that the best way is to just kind of use a bit of a lighter hand and then go over any places that might have skipped, again with that same light hand, so that you don't press down too hard and then the ink doesn't just splash out everywhere and ruin your hard work. So as I said, at the bottom, I wanted to incorporate a space for reflections, and for the lines of this, I used that same pink color to add that same blush pink that we used for the rest of the spread. And just like that, this is my finished March bullet journal. I really love the way that this turned out, especially with all of the gold. I think it's the perfect little accent color. And I also really love, again, painting and drawing flowers. And I love that as I go and I walk around the Bay Area or I visit different places, I'm reminded of this bullet journal pretty much everywhere I go. So I thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.